Well, one of the teachers that I work with seems to have a strange quirk in the classroom.
I love me a good quirk.
No, I don't love this one so much. I don't know why this happens, but she seems to... And I want to preface this by saying that outside of this, she is an outstanding teacher. You know, I talk a lot of shit about my job and my schools and some of my coworkers, but she's actually a very good homeroom teacher, you know. All right. This is the one thing that bugs me. During English class, she will intentionally speak pidgin Japanese in class.
Ah, yes. So, like, when you're there, she'll, yes. like, revert to it.
Yes.
What's a good example?
Okay. Well, folks, the phrase wakarimasen means I don't know. Suddenly, when Alex is in the room and the teacher is speaking, it becomes wakarimasen! It's like, yeah, it's... Like, you know how sometimes if you're dealing with somebody who doesn't speak English... sometimes if they're brave enough, they'll try to fake it. They'll try to, or they'll try to use what little English they do have. Right. I guess, you know, she doesn't have enough English to do that. So she bumps down to the next best thing, which is speaking her own language with an accent like she's a yes. foreigner. What the hell is that?
Well, you have the accent. You're halfway there, right?
No. It's like the little kids who did it to me. Like, they think it'll be easier for me to understand?
Yeah.
Yeah,
it's fine if you're a kid, but if you're an adult, it's just like, no.
She did it again with Yoroshiku? It was Yoroshiku! What?
There does seem to be sort of an acceptance of not quite that bad pitch in Japanese, but sort of like the bad pronunciations of things. Okay, so like Hideo Kojima, creator of Metal Gear, right? Everybody here calls him Kojima.
And Kojima, yeah.
He'll introduce himself that way, you know?
That's right.
Like, they'll do that with their names or, and some other stuff.
Or Toro Inoue.
Yes, right. Yeah. Yeah. So, I mean, that happens with names a lot, I've noticed. Like, people will intentionally mispronounce their names when really it's not that big.
You're right. You're absolutely right. And I think now I'm confused about how to actually pronounce the name of the city that I used to live in, because the foreigner pronunciation is Nagoya.
Right.
And in Japanese, I read it as Nagoya. It's three characters. Na-go-ya.
Right.
It's Nagoya. I hear it, Nagoya. But then sometimes I hear Japanese people say Nagoya. Well, only when they're talking to me, though.
Yeah. Like,
that's the English pronunciation. Oh, that's the English pronunciation of Nagoya. I guess I have to say that now when I'm talking to this guy.
Yeah, exactly.
But this situation, the classroom situation, I, first of all, thought I was, either having a dream or a stroke or something, and I did a double take. I did like you know the episode of Seinfeld with the glasses, and Elaine sells the glasses to Mr. Lippman, and
that's
then
right.
He's standing up there with Jake Jarmel at the podium, and Jake Jarmel does that kind of double take. I did that double take. That's the one I did. I pulled that move. Yeah, I'm like, where did you get those glasses? I mean,
where'd you
so
get
no
language?
Megane wa. No, sorry.
So, but this is one of those things that you can't really bring up, right?
No, not really.
So.
Yeah, I can't.
You're kind of stuck with it?
Yeah, not much I can do here. But you know what?
You use extra, extra polite Japanese in bringing it up?
Well, how do you mean?
Well, I mean, just sort of like, first of all, you'll surprise her just by speaking Japanese.
I'll just wait around the corner. Oh.
Right. No. Oh. I'm surprised by speaking Japanese, and if it's extra polite, well, then, you know, it's the extra mile. That's how I see it. I may be
completely
off base.
Some of that does work, yeah.
I think it's worth a try.
I don't like using super polite Japanese a lot, mostly because, and this is completely stupid of me, it creates this image of, all of my Japanese came from a classroom, and I don't have any practical experience.
Sure.
Because that's what they teach you first, is the super polite stuff. That's what happened to me, is I studied Japanese in the classroom for 3 or 4 years, came to Japan, couldn't hold a fucking conversation casually, because I never learned casual Japanese.
Yeah.
I had to unlearn, not unlearn, but I had to sort of cover all the bases again to speak casually.
Yeah. And now you're fully this jive-talking Japanese guy.
Oh, I speak jaivu.
That's not what I meant.
Oh, sorry. I was thinking of something to say for that so we could...
Jive Manor.
I used to live there.
there. It is time once again for No More Whoppers. How is everybody doing? I'm your host, Ray Barnholt, breeder of boxer dogs that can also box. And with me, as always, some sort of ape man, Alex Fraoli.
Ook, ook!
How you doing?
Doing pretty well. How you doing?
Well, I've had a weird week, I would say.
What
I don't know if I should get into it right now, but...
Well, you should. Isn't that what the show is for?
Well, I mean, I don't know if you maybe you had something more important to say. I don't know. Maybe you got married and I didn't know about it or something.
You know what? Even if I did get married, I want to hear news from Ray.
Right? All right. Fair enough. Fair enough.
Hashtag right. Ray News. Right.
Is that ascending caps or with like a underscore in between them? Or
hashtag you know you Ray win.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Speaking of, you know, crap. sorry, I'm interrupting you before we've even done anything. I thought, until I heard you say LinkedIn a couple episodes ago, I seriously thought it was supposed to be LinkedIn.
What?
Because you don't capitalize a letter so that it looks like a lowercase letter. Capital I looks like a lowercase L.
Yeah.
Am I not? Yes, thank you, Alex. How am I not supposed to read LinkedIn?
We.
Anybody else? Did anybody else read LinkedIn? Come on, I feel like an idiot now.
Oh, well, you're the one with the crickets drop. That is spectacular. That's all I gotta say.
Where can I go to find people that, you know, have the same sorts of problems as me?
Banadil.
Yeah, that's a pretty healthy support group. Oh, boy, I don't even know what to say to that.
So how are you?
I'm speechless. Okay, well. Yeah, I'm okay, but... You know, something weird happened to me this week. I did tell you about this, Alex.
Yes.
But at the time, it was not so much a story. It was just sort of a weird situation. But now it's going to be a story.
Here we go. Just going to drop the bomb.
Everybody get ready. So, you know, a couple weeks ago, I talked about getting a new 3DS.
Yes.
Because I wanted a different color, because I sort of feel weird, you know, having it out in public and sort of the fear of... people coming up and asking what it is or whatever, or noticing me or just trying to engage me in conversation when I don't really want that to happen. I just want a plain colored thing to hold and not have people, you know, immediately recognize it as a Nintendo or whatever. I'm going to whip it out in public. Please, that's okay. Well, that was well timed, I guess. Now, I also said that I don't mind it with, like, an iPhone or an iPad because everybody has one of those.
Right, they're everywhere.
They're everywhere, super popular, but... now I'm going to have to take the iPad out of that. Moving the iPad back into the embarrassment column.
Why is that?
So this week, I decided to take my new iPad out and my new keyboard with it and go to the park. You know, try something else because, you know, I sometimes have trouble writing things that I need to get done. And so I thought maybe go into the park, which is fairly close to my house. Just go there and, you know, chill out and see what I can get done. So I take the walk, I go to the park, and everything's going fine. And I sit down at a bench, completely empty area. It's a weekday afternoon, you know, it's just a little bit past lunchtime, so nobody's really there. It's like 1 p.m. And so I just find this little bench, and I put my bag on the top, and I get my iPad out, and I get the keyboard out, and I set everything up. And really, not 2 minutes later, I see from the corner of my eye somebody approaching. But I just let it go. It's no big deal, right? The guy's probably just gonna go sit on another nearby bench and, you know, have lunch or whatever, I assume. But then the figure in the corner of my eye gets a little bit bigger, and a little bit bigger, and eventually I notice he's actually now wanting to talk to me. And by the way, I have my headphones in my ears, so, you know, I'm focusing on that, so I can't really hear anything anyway. So I see this guy's finally trying to get my attention, so I, you know, twist my head a little bit to the right, and I go, yeah, what's up? And he goes, is that an iPad? I go, yeah. One or two? It's a three, actually. I go, oh, yeah, I got one of those, yeah. I go, yeah.
It's in my van.
Yeah. Yeah, I should also mention, this was an older man. I mean, not like elderly, but he was like early 50s, I'd say. So I was like, okay, yeah. Right, and that pretty much died there, and he went ahead and did, in fact, just go ahead and sit at the adjacent bench and eat his lunch or whatever. And by then, I'm just, like, ruined. Like, my day is ruined now.
Oh, why'd you have to talk to me?
It was not, I swear to God, it was not even 2 minutes. It had to be less than that. The minute I sat down and had everything out and set up, this guy approaches. Out of nowhere, basically. Because the rest of the park was pretty much empty.
Are you saying he was a ghost?
I probably.
Okay.
You know.
It was an afternoon just like today.
Right.
I don't know.
And then he said, if you build it, they will come. I didn't know what that meant.
Oh, man, what if it was the ghost of Steve Jobs?
No.
Didn't look like him?
It was a black guy.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay.
Not that.
I say, oh, really, as if I didn't know that they could age. Oh, really? Oh, elderly black guy.
Well, I know a lot of them. Once they shave their heads, they look pretty young. So we can.
Oh, yeah.
It's very, amazing.
Very Samuel L. Jacksonian.
Exactly. And we all love him.
We do.
So, you know, it's like... Not 2 minutes after I pull this thing out, it's like already somebody's noticing it and wanting to talk to me about it. I'm just like, oh, God damn it. And, you know, I just basically stalled for a minute, you know, sort of like fake typed or whatever on the iPad. Then I had to, then I got up and left. The thing was that it was too windy anyway, so I wouldn't have stayed there long.
Oh, yeah, when it's too windy to type, the keys don't register, the iPad can get blown away.
No, it was blowing really hard in my face, and I didn't like that, okay? I don't like the wind that much, Alex. Is that all right with you?
You're a good friend. I'm Ray.
Wrong! Wrong, asshole!
Well, you showed me.
Yeah. But, you know, as much as, you know, I was sort of... jarred by that whole experience, it was also just kind of stupid. On
when
his,
is a Ray on, not on a Ray? Part. When he's a jarred.
Okay. This show's sorry. Going places, I gotta say.
I'm sorry! It's what I do!
It is. It is what you do, yeah. But it was just as much his fault. I mean, first of all, I had my headphones in.
He was trying to...
And
well,
even
okay.
if he didn't have... I know, hold on. You could at least see that I had some sort of black dot in my ear with a line, black line leading from it. I mean, that would at least signify that, you know, I couldn't really hear you that well anyway. Second of all, if you already have an iPad, then leave me the fuck alone. Would you please? It's an almost empty park, and I know that we're in the Bay Area and all that, but I'm not really interested in talking tech with you.
Yeah.
You know, I clearly just sat down at this bench to relax and try and get some work done, and that was completely destroyed from him and, of course, the wind, like I said. So it was just one of those weird experiences. And for me, of course, like I've said, it was my stupid social anxiety that sort of ruined the whole thing as well. And I'm just like, okay, well, great. This is my entire intent was to just... you know, whip it out in public, and then, you know, just use it to
whip it out in public.
And I didn't even get to do that for more than 2 minutes.
Well, I think a lot of people are going to say, oh, he was just a 50-ish guy trying to be nice and have a conversation and maybe make a friend. But on the other hand, yeah, I do agree that you were clearly sending messages that you were not to be bothered.
Yeah, no, I get that argument, though, of course. You know, wouldn't it be a better world if we all were much friendlier
to
each other?
I mean, I get it in Japan sometimes. If an old person wants to start talking, I can do that sometimes. Yes. Then it gets weird, though, when they start, like, wanting to do an English lesson, like, and I just want to have my beer.
Yes.
It's like, all right, buddy, I'm kind of busy. Oh, yeah, that's actually a good parallel. I would sometimes, when I used to go to the Cooper's, my favorite bar, I would sit there, and there'd be salarymen who'd come in, and try to, you know, get some English conversation practice going. And I would be so drained after a day of work, I wouldn't have the patience for it.
Yeah.
And I would just stop talking to them. I would just not stop. Or I would give, you know, one-word responses. Like, where are you from? America. What state? Pennsylvania. Oh, but one time I did that, and the guy pulled out his iPhone and started looking up the Wikipedia entry for Pennsylvania. And then starts dazzling me with his command of facts.
Yes.
He's like, oh, your state flower is the such and such. Oh, yeah, it sure is. Yeah, your state dog is the whatever. Oh, yeah, I didn't know that. Okay.
Cheese state.
Yes, it is sometimes called the cheese state.
But no, I get that. But, you know, it's a little bit weird when, you know, I am mostly alone. And all of a sudden this person appears out of nowhere and decides to chat me up for really no good reason at all. But, you know, if it was just any other situation where I also didn't have my headphones in, then fine. You can try and, you know, chit-chat me as much as you want.
Wait a minute, hang on. I'm still distressed at the abruptness with which he appeared. We've ruled out ghosts, okay? Not ghosts.
Yeah.
How do you feel about wood nymph?
That's also a good possibility. It was a fairly wooded park.
Warlock's familiar.
I don't know what that is. Is that like Loch Ness?
Yes. A gigantic body of water moving toward you. Containing or not containing a mythical beast.
Right. Shaped like an older black man.
Yes. Ghost of Christmas Future.
So I don't know if I'll be back.
Oh, boy.
Because I don't want to really risk seeing that guy again.
That's the thing about writing in public. I never feel comfortable writing in public. Like, tweeting in public is the most I can do.
Yeah.
If I'm writing outside, it's on a porch or a balcony. I like to do that.
Yeah.
I wrote a lot of my college papers on my porch in my apartment in Ohio, mm-hmm. you know, during that time. That was a lot of fun. Sunny day. You sit out there with a pot of coffee and you write.
Right. Yeah. But yeah, I was just really upset at the situation that I went to the park. It was all nice. I found a nice, quiet, mostly empty place to do the work. And then it just all comes crashing down. It wasn't very fun, I gotta say. Alex, you've talked before about your telecom problems with NTT, getting your internet set up.
Yes, I have.
And there was that brief period where you were on one of those 3G pod things, right?
Yes, I was. The WiMAX.
So I wanted to get one of those here.
Oh.
Because I thought it'd be a neat idea. To go ahead and take that iPad out to the park. And I only have a Wi-Fi iPad, so, you know, I could use that and go somewhere and just, you know, write or check on Twitter or email, you know, wherever I really wanted to.
Yes.
So I decided to get one of those from a company called True Connect. And what their big thing is that they have a very low rate. You know, they charge you by the megabyte, but it's really a very good rate. You don't have to pay a lot a month to keep it going. And I heard good things about it, so I decided to get that. And I ordered one of their MiFi thingamadoos. So I thought, okay, I was all set. So it finally arrives, and I go to set it up. And you have to activate it, which means you have to go to the website and go through the process, make an account, and all that stuff. And so I was doing that. Everything was fine for the most part. And then it actually got to the big blue activate button to go through the process to set up the device.
Here it comes.
Yep. Oh, God, it's going to be working pretty soon. And then it sort of flips back to this weird error screen and then flips me back out to the serial number entry form. All right. Well, then I just put in the same serial number for the device.
All right, it's going to work this time. You
know, and then it says it's already in use. So I can't really go forward at this point.
Wait, what?
Yeah, it apparently activated, except it errored out. So somewhere in their system, it is listed as activated. But the thing is that I still didn't get to create an account.
Oh.
So I got to enter all my credit card information and all that, and I got to make an account and password and all that. But that error screen didn't actually go ahead and finalize the making of the account. So if I went back and, you know, tried it another way, like logged into what I thought was my account... it just said that account doesn't exist.
I'm not an expert, but that sounds very dumb.
Yeah, you might say it is.
Okay.
With a capital D.
Did you call somebody?
Almost.
On the telephone?
No.
Not just open your door and shout, "Hey, so get on in here! What the hell is this?"
No, I did not do that. So I went through the regular support form. And I just explained the problem. I said, I figured that they could help me through that. So I just said, look, here's the thing. I tried to activate it. It didn't really work, I guess. And now it says
here
it's
it
activated.
Comes.
So if you could just reset it or something, that'd be good.
They're going to reset it.
Not yet, Alex.
All right.
So.
I'm holding my breath here.
That was sent through the form. And that takes about 2 days for them to get back to me.
Oh, boy. And hang on, is the big reveal coming up soon? Because I want to get ready.
Not too soon.
Okay. Well, let me know when it's coming. You know what? Hang on. I'm gonna prep now, and then when it comes, I'm gonna let it out. So let me prep right now.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah. No. Okay.
Now keep going.
So I get a response back. You know, a couple days later, I think it was a couple days, and said, okay, yeah, everything's set up again. We reset the device. So you can go ahead and activate it again. So I went back to the website, just did as they said, same as before, and it worked.
Yay!
It was apparently activated, so now I could use the device, right?
Hey, congratulations!
Right, yeah. I thought, okay, this is it. Now I can go to that park again, maybe, and experience 3G for like a half a minute before some other guy tries to ask me what that is.
What is that, 3G?
Yeah,
wow, we went to the exact same old man character.
No, that was good. Great minds. And then I turn on the device and I tried and set it up and doesn't seem to be really working. It's not really loading anything off the internet. So,
oh boy.
I log into the device because it's basically a router and it has like a router setup page on it.
Right.
And I'm seeing that after I turn it on, it attempts to connect to the 3G network and then immediately disconnects. Yeah. And it just keeps doing that. Like, it will not actually end up connecting to the network. It craps out after, like, a second after being turned on. Yeah, didn't really work out the way I thought it would. So, again, I email them. And I say, well, okay, I activated my device and everything seemed okay. Everything looks as though it should be, but it keeps disconnecting and all that stuff. And then I wait another day because, you know, the cycle of, you know, work hours and whatever, somebody's got to check the emails and all that stuff.
The circle of life.
Right. So they get back to me again, and the tech rep guy says, I'm sorry you're having trouble. Could you please give me your phone number and a good time to call you, and I will get back to you about this.
Ooh.
So, well, you know, I'm not liking that too much because, again, we go to the social anxiety part, and I start to get a tinge like, ugh, I got to be on the phone now.
I hate using the phone.
Yeah. That's just, that's me.
I rely very heavily on body language and facial expression, and you put me on the phone, and it's like I'm closing my eyes and talking to somebody.
I'm surprised. After all the other tales of your ADD on the show.
Shut up! Good for you!
Not surprised. So I sort of... Okay, well, I mean, I have to basically do it, right? So I just say, okay, go. This is my number, and you can call me at or after noon tomorrow. All right, which would have been today when we're recording this.
Okay.
Now, maybe I should have just said, you know, just call me. Yeah, whatever. Right then and there. Should have seen what happened instead of making them wait a day because they never called. Nobody called today. So I'm still stuck with a fairly broken device. And now that it's Friday night, I'll just have to wait until Monday to go ahead and call them myself this time and finally see if I can get a solution going, which I should have done, I know, a long time ago at the beginning. I guess I'd like to explore all possible options. So that's my little tale so far.
Well, if the guy calls, be really nice, take him out. Go see That's My Boy. Have you seen that? You should go see it.
With
the guy, you know. Right. Get to know each other. Have dinner.
Wait all the gabagool. Yeah.
That would be awkward. Yeah, for me, at least. If I showed up to some restaurant with a date and they said, excuse me, sir, we're all out of gabagool. My immediate response is...
Where's the gabagool?
Yeah. Followed by...
Wait all the gabagool?
Really the same question, I guess.
Well, it's, you know, Italians will do that.
Yeah.
Where's my cheese balls?
Ah! How do you say that in Italian?
You would know.
Doco mi cheese ballos.
We.
Yeah, there we go.
Getting a good use out of the old classic drops this week.
It's
just folks, like old times, right, Alex?
It's classics week here at No More Whoppers.
You think we'd change after 20 episodes, but no.
Nope.
Everything tastes like pee to me.
So yes, I'll have perhaps further news on that front.
I but hope at least, you do.
You know,
I hope it's good news.
I hope so too. I mean, I already have an internet connection, so this isn't that big of a deal. It's basically a toy. It's not like your thing where you were basically stranded out there in the digital grid, yeah, so to speak, superhighway, CD-ROMs and whatnot.
Yeah, and then it took me over a month to get internet, and when I did, Jerry fucking Lewis shows up with his crew of numbskulls and can't even install it. Sorry, I'm Alex.
Really?
I was just so angry about that. Folks, what was that episode? Something or other? 12, 13?
Yeah, that was...
Folks, go back in time. You can hear my harrowing ordeal trying to get internet installed by bumbling buffoons.
Bumbling buffoons.
Yeah, who don't know how to tell time.
Or I think they were just trying to dick you over.
Don't know how to put an up-to-date installer on their disk.
They were trolling you, LOL.
They were.
You mad?
There we go. That's a meme, right? Yeah.
Yeah. So really, those were the two big high points of my week. I got nothing else except that I went to the bank again in an iron shirt. Still loving that iron.
What about the iron chic?
Shirt.
Sorry. Should we take a break?
Do you want to?
Yes.
That badly?
Unless you have something.
So long, that'll play.
Let's take a break.
All right. Myself a plan that should be the envy of most any man. I'd sneak it out of there in a lunchbox in my hand. Now, getting caught meant getting fired, but I figured I'd have it all by the time I retired. I'd have me a car worth at least $100,000. I'd get it one piece at a time, and it wouldn't cost me a dime. You'll know it's me when I come through your town. I'm gonna ride around in style, I'm gonna drive everybody wild, cause I'll have the only one there is around. So the very next day when I punched in with my big lunchbox with help from my friend, I left that day with a lunchbox full of gear. I've never considered myself a thief, but GM wouldn't miss just one little piece, especially if I strung it out over several years. The first day I got me a fuel pump, and the next day I got me an engine and a trunk. Then I got me a transmission and all the chrome. The little things I could get in my big lunchbox, like nuts and bolts and all four shocks, but the big stuff we snuck out my buddy's mobile home. Now up to now my plan went all right, till we tried to put it all together one night.
All right, we're back. I feel nice and refreshed. How about you, Alex?
I feel fantastic. I got a fresh cup of coffee here.
Good, good. You know, I was looking on the internet during the break, and I found a piece of news from your home region.
What?
Here's the headline. Ohio diner owner dies hours after President Obama visits.
Oh, I saw that. Yeah, I saw that on the BBC before we started recording today. Yeah.
Yeah.
She was only 70, which isn't very, it isn't super old.
Well, within hours of President Obama's visit to her Akron, Ohio diner, Josephine Ann Harris, who had been ill for some time, was dead. Yep, that's the story. And it's from Ohio, so I thought of Alex.
That's not my home.
Good for you!
Well, I guess there's no need for me to speak when you do the speaking for me.
Well, what... Okay, Alex, what were you going to say?
I don't identify as an Ohioan.
You know what? I don't even know what you're supposed to identify as. I have you being born at least 5 different places and growing up at least 12, so I don't really know. I still don't know your whole story.
Born in Hawaii, not Kenya. Let me repeat, not Kenya. All right? All right. Maybe you don't have a quote-unquote birth certificate.
Oh, man. What if this podcast had a legion of Alex birthers? I'll tell you what, I'll stake claim first. I'll be the forefront of
it. Wait a minute, what exactly is the claim? If I wasn't born in America, that I'm not Alex?
No, just that I need to know where you were really born in.
I was born in North Tarrytown Hospital in North Tarrytown in New York State in 1983.
Yes.
As a baby.
Uh-huh. Correct. I mean, most people are babies, yeah.
Yeah, most people.
Do you have a timestamp on that? Because that would help.
I think it was in the morning around 8 a.m. or 9 a.m.
Uh-huh. Okay, yeah. Good enough. Good time to go get some breakfast after.
Yeah, that's what I did. I popped out of there. I'm like, I need Eggs Benedict. And we ran down the road. There was a diner.
No. We have Sanka.
We don't have a big bowl.
Yeah. And then you were on your way, and the rest is history.
Alex!
Your reactions to the drop are now funnier than the drop.
God
damn. What up, Al?
Still surprise me sometimes, is all.
Well, that's the function of the drop.
All right. Folks, check it out. I want to revisit a segment that we haven't done in a while. Mm-hmm. And I've gotten a lot of...
Teacher nicknames.
Teacher nicknames. There's a guy who always drinks his tea and then makes a face.
Drinky tear.
Mr. Drinky tea.
Tea facer.
Oh, face God. They'll let anybody make a podcast.
And then I'd guess, oh, he has a face like Mr. T. And then you go, no, Ray, boo.
We should go back and just do parodies of our old episodes. But I guess that's what the new episodes are, aren't they?
Yeah.
We're just constantly parodying.
It's our unofficial season two.
It's like season one, where we started out all serious, and then season two.
Right.
It's like The Room 2.
Right. Or it's like Breath of Fire, Dragon Quarter. We just redo the whole thing after 2 and 10 or so. I'm sorry. You were saying.
All right. Folks, I'm going to revisit an old segment that we haven't seen in a while.
Guy who doesn't understand Wikipedia.
This week's article.
That's right.
Is North America. North America.
Oh, okay. Place we're both familiar with.
That's right. All right. This is the guy who doesn't understand Wikipedia installment for July 15th, 2012.
Do you need a clackboard?
No, I'm fine.
All right. All right. Here we go. All right. The economy of North America comprises more than 528 million people, 8% of the world population, in its 23 sovereign states and 15 dependent territories. The U.S., Canada, and Mexico have significant and multifaceted economic systems.
Thanks a lot, Obama!
Guy who doesn't understand Wikipedia.
All right.
So yeah, another great segment.
Thank you very much.
No more Whoppers.
Oh, like us on LinkedIn.
No, that'd be recommend on
LinkedIn. No? Okay, fine. Recommend us on LinkedIn.
Yes.
Like us on Facebook. Five stars on iTunes. We're finishing the show, right?
Should we set up a fake profile on LinkedIn for Northern Whoppers with a resume and all that, and people can recommend us?
Oh, yeah. It's a good idea.
No More Whoppers proved itself as a management leader during the time that I worked with it.
Can we do one of those like Photoshops where we combine both of our faces into one face? or like a what will I look like type baby service where you match the parents' faces and produce the child that they would create?
Right, you can do that on a 3DS, can't you?
Sure.
Yeah.
Yeah, we just mix both of our faces and make like a baby that looks like both of us.
Ugh.
No? Because really, the podcast is our baby.
That's true.
Right?
Yeah, it is.
I mean, I love this little guy.
I was hoping you'd have a baby drop to go.
Until he turns on us and kills us in our sleep.
There you go. That's good.
Yeah, I was actually searching for a baby drop. Don't actually have one. Well, this is the next best thing.
He's a little kid.
Yeah, no, that's good. That's good enough.
Okay.
All right. Well, you know, we finished our book club.
We did.
So I'm feeling a little bit dry of the things to talk about. Not much happened to Burger King lately.
Steel-cut oatmeal versus traditional. Where do you stand?
I really don't know what the difference is.
Well, steel-cut has something to do with the purity of the oatmeal.
I just thought maybe it was...
I believe it's a more precise method of cutting the oatmeal. That may not be true.
I don't know why it would be such an in vogue thing, though.
I don't understand why anyone would try to cut oatmeal anyway. It's like, it's goopy. Like,
well, no, I mean, when it's
you
dry,
you eat it with a
Alex,
spoon, right? What?
It's separated at first, you know, when it's dry. It's dry oats, and then...
I don't understand.
But then later, the consumer adds, you know, the liquid to soften it up and make it all gooey and
you don't
delicious.
Get, you don't get oatmeal from oatmeal cows?
No.
Back to school!
Guy who doesn't understand reality. Well, this is the rest of the show. We're running on fumes for the next at least 15 minutes.
Let's just make up a book and say that we read it.
Yeah.
All right, here's a fake book title. Top of the Rock by Warren Littlefield. God damn it! How did I fuck that up?
Maybe we should read Top of the Womp.
All right, so no, I'm the head.
Maybe we should choose a new book. Let's go on Amazon right now and look at some books. Okay?
All right, I like that. All right, I'm getting on Amazon.
All right. I will go to the Kindle store just because, you know, you can't really easily get a paper book.
Okay, while you're doing that, I'm going to check out Self-Help.
Oh, is that what you want to do?
Well,
right
here
on the front page, we have an ad for Oprah's Book Club 2.0.
I'm kind of against the OBC.
Well, we could follow Oprah, I mean... We're both fans.
That's true.
She's reading Wild by Cheryl Strayed.
Who?
I don't know. It's a book that Oprah likes.
Cheryl Strayed? Strayed from what? Hey, folks, thanks. I'm a professional.
That's how it's spelled, actually. But
really?
Yeah. It's a name that's also a sentence.
All right, folks. I've just found Being Happy by David Tuffley.
Yeah. Does it have a rating?
Some
reviews on that.
4 stars, hey.
Four
Kindle
stars?
Edition is free.
Yeah. Oh, really? Really? Oh. Yeah. Well, it must not be that good. I mean, I have some in my wish list. You know, some books that I've had before and read. Like Game Over from David Sheff, you know, the story about Nintendo. Did you ever read that?
No.
Well, maybe you should.
What the hell? Every time I click on a chapter, it just brings me to the copyright. Why would it do that? I want to read the book. I don't want to read the copyright.
Know. I'm not looking at it with you.
Thanks a lot, Obama. Oh, we did that.
Yeah. We could read the story of the Yugo, the rise and fall of the worst car in history.
I don't know. It sounds really in-depth.
Price dropped 23%. It's only $10. Actually, it's 271 pages, so it's actually shorter than Top of the Rock.
All right, 101 Ways to Improve Yourself by Seth Gruner. Let's see if
Gruner.
I can read an excerpt. Gruner.
Is that spelled G-R-O-O-N-E-R?
G-R-U-N-E-R.
Oh, so close.
All right.
That's my second guess.
101 Ways to Improve Yourself. Introduction.
Yeah.
I've written this book, or list, actually, for something to do that is productive and helpful. Having a bit of spare time in my life, I decided to do something worthwhile that I hope will benefit some of the human race a little. This list is not very difficult or intricate. I'm not a therapist, doctor, philosopher, or anything really. Well, I'm closing this book.
Guy's
not even a professional.
Yeah.
15 ways to get into a better mood. 1, drink water. 2, exercise. 3, eat chocolate. 4, meditate. 5, keep away from negative people. All right, folks, we're ending the podcast.
Yeah, that's not going to work out.
No.
You are very negative to me.
How am I very negative?
I don't know. You're always disagreeable. I don't know what it is.
I'm disagreeable in general, though. I'm very hard, very difficult to work with.
You might say cantankerous.
Yes.
Yeah.
Well, I wouldn't say that.
I mean, I mentioned this to you last night, even.
What?
I said we can't seem to agree on anything that we don't create.
That's true.
I can't get you to play a certain game.
Well, I play Monster World 4. I'm just going to keep citing that until I die.
Yeah, right. Until I say new games, then you're like, oh, yeah, I guess you're right, dude. Although there was a little bit, I must say, it did turn around. You were drinking a lot of Arnold Palmer's.
That's true. I had another one
tea
today.
Tea lemonade.
Delicious.
So I decided to try some. Because, you know, I'd seen around the store. I didn't really try it. I'm not a big tea guy.
There's a guy who always drinks his tea and then makes a face.
Drinky tear.
Mr. Drinky Tear.
T-Facer.
Oh, God. They'll let anybody make a podcast.
I've just had to try it, and now I'm drinking it all the time.
Yeah.
Well, 2 days in a row. And so I took the bait there. I mean, we agree on a drink. And I think we do on some other drinks as well, but, you know.
Most
other things, it's so hard to get you to like something.
Coke Zero.
Yeah, okay.
Pepsi Next. Is it Next or Nex? Because in Japan, in Japan, there's no T, it's Nex. Is it the same?
Yes.
It's,
okay. No, here it's with the T.
With a T?
It's buried under a big T.
Because I was going to say, if it was N-E-X, then around Halloween time, they should sell it as Pepsi Nex.
Yeah.
N-E-C-K-S. No?
Right. No, no, I get it. I get it.
And the top of the can looks like it's been decapitated. Right. Come on, folks. I'm giving it away for free. Pepsi, call me.
You are. That is a good idea, I got to say. For Halloween, yeah. Oh, but then you get parents complaining.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, we can't have kids drinking this kind of imagery. I know that sentence doesn't make sense, but they would say it.
A Pepsi can that looks like Simon Belmont's holding Dracula's head.
Oh, well, that tipped me back. I mean, okay, I said the whole thing last night because you didn't think that a girl I thought was cute on TV wasn't cute.
That's true. I thought she looked like any girl from anybody's graduating high school class.
Okay, well, let me add some context to this.
Okay.
I was watching the show The Choice
Biggest Loser
on Fox. Oh. It's a silly little sort of dating show. It's like The Voice, except it's The Choice. Instead of people singing, it's a bunch of women or
people
men
flinging
on the show. Oh. And the opposite sex guys are behind chairs.
I think you can just say the guys.
I was trying to
sort of imply.
Be fair.
Okay.
Gender There's equality. A lot of sensitivity swirling around these days on the internet about that sort of thing.
Okay. So the female-gendered girls.
Right, yes. They're in these big chairs, and they can't see the girls. They can only hear them until they pull a lever, and then they flip the chairs around to actually see them.
You say lever, you don't say lever?
I say it both ways. I grew up in a weird place.
What about the soap?
That's lever, yeah.
Okay.
Because it's also the company Unilever.
Oh. It means one lever.
Right. And rail means rail. So it's kind of a stupid show. I wouldn't, you know, really otherwise watch it except I was just killing time, but there was a really cute girl on it. I thought she was really cute. And then I brought it up to Alex, and I even took a picture, and I showed him, and he was like, oh, I guess our definitions of cute are on different graphs. And I'm like, what the fuck, Alex? First, I mean,
what?
That was going in my head. It's like, what the fuck is your problem?
No, it's...
It was a really super cute girl, I thought.
It's not, well,
and
again, we
like,
have
no.
Very, we have dairy, we have different definitions of cute
I,
and attractiveness.
I think in this case, no, I don't see the problem. I just can't articulate it, I guess. I would say, though, that, you know, maybe you needed to see her in motion. So I'll show you stills.
I really don't believe that cuteness is expressed in motion.
What?
Not completely. I mean, it certainly can be, but...
Okay. No, but...
Like, if you see a photo of a cute cat doing a cute cat thing, and you say, yeah, I don't know, I'd have to see him in motion. That sounds a little weird.
So you wouldn't even consider it. I think you should...
No.
At least think that maybe there's the possibility if, you know...
Hey, the Mona Lisa sucks. When are we going to animate it? When are we going to animate famous paintings of history? Because I don't see any beauty in them at all, as it is.
Now you're just being antagonistic to me.
Yes, I am.
Just because you don't agree.
You're a good friend.
But I'm just trying to get you to...
Sorry, I'm really having fun.
Too much.
This game is a big shock to me because up until now, I thought that we had very, very similar standards and tastes, standards and practices when it came to identifying attractiveness.
I think so. I think we're still mostly on parity.
Then what happened here?
I have no idea, especially since, you know, I gotta say, I think this girl didn't really look too different from maybe some ex-girlfriends of yours.
That's ridiculous. I've never dated any... Well, there was the one. Okay.
I'm just saying, maybe you had some sort of subconscious reaction to that.
No.
I mean, she wasn't exactly identical, but I'm saying she's sort of on the same level.
No, if... It,
a
no,
similar
I,
plane of cuteness.
I do not
say.
Think so.
Well, okay. You don't think a lot of things that, you know... that were brought up in this discussion that I don't agree with.
She looked like if she were a superhero, her name would be Regularo.
No.
Regulara.
No.
No.
You know, I respond to cuteness. I actually do do not respond as well to, let's say, gorgeousness. You know, like a supermodel class sort of high cheekbones.
That,
you know.
Yeah, that always feels a little bit too artificial to me to be
appealing in any way. To me, it's actually kind of plain.
Really?
It sort of inverses out to plain to me.
I find it boring.
So I respond more to cuteness.
There you go.
You know, it's a different kind of beauty, but something that is better appreciated by me. But like you said, yes, I think we're mostly on the level most of the time. And I don't know what happened here.
Guy who doesn't understand Wikipedia.
Sorry?
That was, it's a classic, what can I say? But yeah, I guess, you know, like I said, we can't agree on everything, but usually when it's things we create, it's okay.
For example?
We like each other's stuff.
I like your, scrawl.
Yes. I made the podcast logo, you liked that?
I think scrawl is like the best webcomic I've ever seen.
Okay, thanks. I like some things you've done, and okay. Yeah, so I think we got a good, you know, track record.
Well, let's not start sucking each other's dicks quite yet.
I like your drops, some of them. Not all of them. I'm not going to name which ones, because you will just play it, and that
so long, that'll play.
That's a, that's a new favorite, you know? Yeah, that's climbing the chart.
That'll play.
I mean, we've been friends for a long time, and we've created things together with each other, for each other,
well,
among
each
other.
My opinion on this, Top of the Rock?
What?
All right, we're reading Top of the Rock by Warren Littlefield.
Yes, right, yes. Chapters 17 and 18 through 30.
Julia Louis-Dreyfus snaps and destroys half a city block. My thinking on this is that you and I are such harsh critics of pretty much everything in the world, especially humor. that when we don't typically want to turn it on each other, I think we like to be supportive. But then these very harsh filters are still, you know, enabled when we're looking at something that may have been suggested or promoted by the other person, like this girl.
Yeah.
That for some reason is being called cute.
Right, yeah. Yeah. I get that. And it doesn't help that you make much snippier comments than I do.
Well, yeah.
Like, if I don't agree with something, I'll try and, you know,
you're more
take
like,
it a little easier.
You tend to show your rage through just a blazing apathy.
That makes sense, yeah.
I like to take the snippy route, which, right. You know, I'm not proud of, but sometimes it's very therapeutic. Sometimes it's very fun.
Yeah, it's very therapeutic. Yeah, absolutely. Yep.
You know, I have
no regard for the other person on the other end.
Oh yeah, like
very therapeutic for you.
Well, it's easier because other people aren't actually, you know, living organisms; they're robots.
Do you not understand that maybe I get a little bit punched in the gut when you don't agree that some girl is cute, for example?
Why? But why? We don't have to agree on everything.
I know that, but you're still my best friend, and I would expect, you know, some sort of agreement. At some level, not
I think
you saying, well, I guess we're just different.
I think we can only agree on one thing.
I'm Ray.
Well,
here's the thing,
we brought
though.
This up last week, didn't we?
Yes. Here's the thing, though. It's not like you brought her home one day and said, hey, Alex, guess what?
Yeah. But
I'm getting married to Sarah Plainenthal that I found. And it's a girl on TV that you snapped a picture of with your phone. This is not even somebody that you
know. Which is why I was saying maybe you.
Why
just
is it a big deal
on the show?
No, in motion, I still don't understand.
Would help a little bit.
If I see her in motion, oh yeah, she's very cute.
Well, I guess we can't prove that either way.
Well, can we find a clip on YouTube or something?
Maybe.
Hey, let me search up. What do I search for? Plain Jane.
She wasn't plain, you asshole. Okay, but no, wait, what if...
What was her name? I bet it was Sarah. Sarah?
No.
Okay.
Angelica.
Oh, Jesus. Angelica Panganiben? Scandal
didn't have
with
last
Derek.
Names. No last name.
Angelica Zambrano. Well, I'm searching that anyway. Because I think we can compromise here.
It's a fun name, yeah.
Where's my cheese balls?
There she was now.
from YouTube user Passionate Latino. All right. I don't know. I just...
What is going on now?
What was the name of the show? Choices?
The choice.
Guided by choices.
Interview. Oh, yeah, GBC. Love the band.
No, I'm not seeing it. All right. Folks, write in.
Thank God. Really, I didn't want it to escalate to that. Because then you would just watch it, and then you would just go, yeah, no, fuck you, Ray.
No, well, yeah, because I've already, well.
Yeah, I know how this goes. Okay,
why is it so important that I agree on this?
It's not important.
Apparently it is.
I just wanted to talk about it.
Apparently it sends you into a death spiral.
You're the one raising your voice.
Because it's fun. I'm Alex. Case in point.
No, I mean, at the end of the day, I don't really care. But I thought it was something interesting to talk about. I thought it was interesting at the time to bring it up, but you didn't agree, so
I don't know.
It hurt a little. What if someone like that, was my girlfriend, and I did bring
then
it up?
Then I would do what I do with everyone else and fake nice.
All
right. Right?
Yeah.
I go out, I see a friend at the Coopers or something, and he's got his girlfriend there, and I... find her to be annoying. Yeah. What?
And she's an uggo.
No, I didn't say that. I just, just not my cup of green tea. I just made that up.
And lemonade.
Not my cup of Arnold Palmer.
Yeah. Not much of an Arnie, as we'd like to say. No.
Well, I just imagined my Japanese friend dating Arnold Schwarzenegger, which is funny in its own right.
It is. That's a good dream to have.
But, in those situations, you fake nice, and, maybe I don't like this person, but it's my friend, and I trust my friend's decision.
Yep.
My friend knows this person on a level that I don't, so I have to trust them. Here, you just know the TV. Right?
I know, but...
So I don't have to fake nice with you.
We'll just have to see how this plays out.
All right.
I think it's Japan, honestly. I think Japan is messing with your brain a little bit. You got that yellow fever.
No, well, yes, but this has nothing to do with this.
It might. I think it might.
I really don't think so. I think it's just a very simple difference in how we assess physical attractiveness.
Uh-huh.
For example, you like...
You're a man-like creature.
You go for familiar men-like creatures.
Right.
Named Koopa.
Yeah.
I go for two burly plumbers. Can
two
we get along?
Burly plumbers. The Mario Brothers.
Yeah, yeah. Let's not make it too obvious.
I'm from Italy.
Can we? Are we just playing all our drops now?
Everything tastes like pee to me.
They all link up.
Man a deal.
What's that?
I have this whole Alex board here.
Oh, yeah. All of mine link up, too.
We'll make that as a donation bonus.
Guy who doesn't.
I'm.
It's 5 hours of mind-numbing crap.
I really don't want to hear any more whoppers.
I'm just. I'm curious of what, if anything, we'll agree on next. What we will actually agree on. What will it be?
Well, hang on. Let's think about this. We agree. I think the thing we agree most on might be video games.
Yes, but not everyone.
No, but no. It's
okay, we both thing, like Dragon Quest.
The thing that we agree most on, not that we agree a lot.
Oh, most, yes. Okay, I understand. Well, I mean, also, that's been part of our lives the most.
That's true.
So, I mean, we have a good frame of reference there.
That's true.
But still, if I try to bring up some game with you that's not Monster World 4, you'll be like, oh, yeah, that's a good idea.
Well, it depends. Okay, give me an example.
Even if it's something like a demo, like, Alex, I think you'd really like this game. There's a demo you can download, and he's like, oh, okay, yeah, whatever, gives a shit.
I don't like demos,
I get that attitude back.
I don't like demos. Because if I enjoy it, I'm going to be sad that it's over.
But that's just insane.
Then I'm insane.
Well, I think we found the problem.
It's like people keep recommending TV shows to me. I've heard Breaking Bad is supposed to be phenomenal, and people like Dexter a lot. And the reason I don't watch them is because I know that I am going to like them, and I am going to waste the next several weeks or weekends doing nothing but watching them.
Okay.
And I don't want to lose that time. I want to lose that time, playing a game or doing something else. Yes!
So really it's all based in you having no faith in yourself.
Yes!
That's really troubling.
Yeah, I know.
You might want to explore that a little deeper.
That's what we're doing.
On our new show, Al Deeper.
What?
That's our new show.
Al Deeper?
Deeper.
Oh.
Okay, now let's move on to our next subject, your hearing.
What? Welcome back to No More Whoppers, formerly Words with Fiends. I'm here with Ray Barnhold.
Hi.
And Alex Fraioli.
Hi.
Hey, no, wait a minute.
Oh.
Pretty sure it's me.
Okay.
Folks, we got some feedback.
What up, Al?
Ah, you're right in the ears. Got some feedback from a listener, Ike Wagner, on the subject of nerd stuff in public when you want to say, hey, knock it off.
When you want to say, hey, knock it off. When you want to say, stop that shit.
Wait, what is that? I know that.
When you want to say, I hate you.
What is that? What is that?
No, I make it up.
Oh, I thought that was a song.
It might be. Nothing's original anymore.
Let's look it up.
All right. Oh, here we go.
Oh, what is a song? Oh. All right, shut up. I want to get to this. Now, folks.
I'm shutting up.
Now, this is a story all about how... Okay. You remember a couple weeks ago, I had my infamous cosplay rant.
That's right.
And I sort of, I did go overboard in condemning nerd stuff.
That's right, you did.
It happens sometimes, and our good listener, Ike Wagner, wrote in with an example. He says, y'all's talk about anger and gamer nerds having no concept of public decency reminded me of an incident. I used to work in a store that sold retro games. Once on a busy Saturday, a fellow came into the store. He was playing Final Fantasy VII's boss theme over his cell phone speaker. I don't know if he thought this would earn him nerd cred. Normally, I am reserved and would ignore things like this, but I told him to either turn it off or leave, and he left. It wouldn't have been so bad, but for the fact that he strutted around with FF7's already kind of low-quality boss music playing over a tinny, shitty cell phone speaker as if it weren't severely irritating. I have no doubt in my mind that he immediately went to the GameStop across the road and did the same thing.
Yeah, it's kind of like the opposite of what I do.
You don't want to be noticed at all.
Right.
And this guy is like, I maxed out all my material, motherfuckers! Yeah, right, okay. It's not
Final Fantasy VII, I know what that is.
Yeah.
Come thanks. Ask me about it. Ask me about Final Fantasy VII.
Ask me about my Barrett.
Ask your doctor about...
Ask your doctor about Meteor.
Yeah. Yeah, that's a cute little story. That's definitely
it's,
a good...
Yeah. Because I, again, for the third or fourth week or whatever, I want to stress I am a proponent of clever nerd stuff. Not super clever, because that gets annoying. But, if you're... If you have something about you that you are proud of, that maybe, I kind of want to get away from using the term nerdy because, again, I don't feel like it actually has a meaning anymore. It's like hipster. It's like, well, everybody's a hipster in some way. Everybody's a nerd in some way.
Well, I think nerd is more valid than hipster.
How do you mean?
Hipster is just another way to call somebody a faggot these days.
So. Yeah, that's true.
Nerd is a little bit different. It has different layers.
And I know a guy who... Everybody who is not exactly like him, he thinks is a hipster, which gets really annoying.
Oh, yeah, that sounds familiar.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Anyway. Yeah, he's like, oh, that guy has a hat. What a hipster. All right, it's a hat. Right. Shut up. I was unfairly called a hipster once for using a fountain pen to write in a notebook. the hell is that?
When?
Oh, it was on Twitter. I think the guy was kidding.
Oh, yeah, maybe.
But, yeah, I tweeted a picture of my bar setup. I was sitting at the bar, sitting at a stool with a notebook and my pen. I was taking notes on something.
Yeah.
It might have been when I was still trying to do stand-up comedy. I was trying to write a set. I was trying to come up with jokes. I was sitting there writing with my fountain pen. I tweeted a picture of it, and somebody called me a hipster. I'm like, what? It's a freaking pen. How am I a hipster for liking a fountain pen?
They might have been joking, okay, Alex? It might have been one of those times when somebody wasn't serious and you just needed to calm down.
What, am I steampunk now?
Put down the ice pick.
Because I have a bicycle. All right. How'd you know I was holding an ice pick?
Because I know how you get.
It's an ice pick with gears in it.
Sorry. That's an amazing voice. I love that's that.
That's my new character, Steampunk Larry.
That was really good. Steampunk Larry.
Yeah.
That's offensive to real steampunks.
This watch is 7 inches wide, but it's worth it.
Shut up. I don't care.
Thank you, Heathcliff.
Seriously, no one should terrify the neighborhood.
But yeah, I'd love some more stories like that from anybody else who listens.
Yeah, folks,
basically,
right,
we've had, you know, Ike has said things to us before, and I don't want him to turn into one of those fans of the show who is basically the only fan of the show.
Yeah,
who's
yeah.
the only guy who says things. That's a little bit creepy, and that's not how we want to position him.
No, we want lots of Ike Wagners.
Yes, we do want all sorts of.
Is it? Wait, hang on. Is it Ike Wagners or Ike's Wagner?
I think it's Ike Wagner.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
My bad.
Because, you know, hardly anyone said anything about the book when we read that.
I know.
We didn't help much because we sucked at talking about it.
That's true.
But, I mean, it was basically just Joshua J. Sloan, who did have some good input on the book, but it's not something that we could really, you know, switch to because it was just one person.
And I gotta apologize. Talk about a major gaffe. We had Warren Littlefield on the phone line for the whole discussion, but he was on mute the whole time. Can you believe it? What a knucklehead.
Yeah, you goofball.
My bad.
You just gotta click the thing in. And then,
I'm sorry.
Oh, I also have one too. He sent in some extra audio that he recorded at the same time. He decided to send that into us. Here we go now.
Clooney Tunes!
So, thank you, Warren.
Was he pitching that at the time?
Yeah, I think so.
Because ER had just finished its very successful run.
That's right.
And he decided to come back swimming, swinging. Couldn't even say that when I tried.
Well, you know, you kind of paddle your arms. I just swing your arms when you swim.
It's an underwater show called Clooney Tunes.
Oh, Clooney Tunes, yep. For the third time, I'd like to say, please send in some embarrassing nerd stories.
Yeah, folks, we need some. And you know what? Even if they are about you know what? I have a text file full of my embarrassing nerd stories. I'm going to give you here's a tit for tat deal. If you write in with an embarrassing nerd story, either you or something that you've witnessed, and I will read one from mine.
That's good.
Every week it happens.
Folks, do not let that get away.
One for one. Yeah, this is an amazing deal I have going on here. Because Ray, you know I have a rich / sordid history when it comes to these things.
Yes, I know exactly what you're talking about because awesome. You've told me some of these stories. These are golden opportunities, people.
Yes.
Do not let this slip away.
Right.
Tit for tat.
This is like, you cannot get this.
Story for a story.
There's no other way to get this.
And then have Alex visit you.
And then have Alex visit
in
you.
In costume as Alex.
In costume. Yeah, what?
I'm Alex.
And then, you know, you can
wait
go
a minute.
On it.
I wear like fake Alex prosthetics on my face. I'm just like double Alex. What is that?
That is frightening, but...
What is this? I don't wear gold chains. What is this? Guys!
But you did wear that PlayStation necklace.
Oh,
did I tell a story already?
No, I think I told it.
Yeah, you did. God,
what is it? What is this orange paint that you're putting around my mouth? Oh, gabagool. Okay. All right.
It's an artistic representation.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm just going to show up as this gross caricature of myself.
Oh, fun stuff.
All right, folks, check it out. We were not going to have donor thanks this week because nobody donated until an hour ago. As we were recording segment one.
You might say the 11th hour.
The 11th hour. As we were recording segment one, I checked my email. Lo and behold, a very generous donation, the most generous donation yet, from a Mr. Jason Ariola.
Very nice. Is it triple digits?
That's
what I'm looking for.
Well, you know what? Counting the cents, the pennies, we're going four digits.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh.
And hey, if you want to count the PayPal confirmation number, 17 digits.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, just tell me the amount.
All right. Okay.
Just whisper it in my ear.
I know. I'm not going to tell you the amount.
Right now. Come on.
I will say, I'm going to read him a very special donor thanks message. Just a ballpark at 40 seconds long. Does that sound good?
Yeah.
All right.
And go.
All right, folks. Jason Areola. Check it out. You can find him on Twitter at the same name. It's Jason Areola. And here's a hilarious excerpt tweet. Want to write about video games? Games and Junk is looking for a few staffers. Message me for details if you're interested. You can find him at gamesandjunk.com, where he writes about video softs and such. He's a very generous guy, apparently. And his website seems really good. Here's something interesting I just found out about him. Apparently, an individual's areoli may also change color over time in response to hormonal changes caused by menstruation, certain medications, and aging, citation needed. Most notably, the areolae may darken substantially during pregnancy. Some regression to the original color may occur after the baby is born, though this varies between individuals. All right, thanks, Jason!
And that's just the kind of stuff you can get when you donate.
That's right!
Yeah, that was good. Boy, I hope you pronounced his name right.
Jason.
Yeah, right.
Standard pronunciation on that.
Instead of using that pigeon Japanese.
No. Jason! I don't know what that was. Now, folks, I had something else cooked up as well, because when we sat down to record this, I did not think there were any donors this week. So what I did was, and I'm going to do this every week now, if there are no donors, you know what? Even if there are donors, I don't care. I'm going to read off the people who have liked the Facebook page this week.
Wow, okay. We are just on the acknowledgments here.
Well, I'm grateful because people keep downloading this thing and donating money. And I'm not yelling at you. Am I? You idiot! Okay.
Okay, settle down. Drink some water. For God's sake. Thank you.
So I thought I'd give a little shout-out to the people who liked our Facebook page this past week. Folks, we just crossed 66 likes.
That's good route.
That's a special number, right?
Yeah.
So here we go.
That's where we get our kicks.
This week's likes. All right, folks, check it out. Nagoya local and Ameristralian Rob Fontaine. He's a nice guy that I knew from my tenure at the Coopers. I think he's Australian, but he lived in Los Angeles for a time. 8-4's own John Riccardi, who obviously clicked by mistake. Jesse, changed his name, I see. Jesse Panidu, who is clearly using Facebook under a pseudonym. And spaghetti magnate Rob Bartoli. So thanks, everybody. Thanks for liking the page. Thanks for, welcome to our family. You know, our motto, and I just made this up, when you're here, you're family.
Your family, yes, exactly. Love it.
Thanks for all your help in making No More Whoppers the unstoppable force that it is.
Yes. A juggernaut, if you will.
Yes, a whoppernaut.
A cyclops.
A wolverine.
Yes.
Dazzling. Cerebro. Did you say Hitler?
No. God damn it, get a fucking hearing aid.
Stanley.
Excelsior.
The printed word.
It's my favorite hero. That's a superhero of culture.
Movable type. Okay.
Yes. Good stuff. Good stuff. God, we have a lot of people that we have to shower love on.
We do, because you know we're that. No.
Did I tell you I'm Italian? Let me restate that.
Yeah. Because when you hear your family, like we said.
No, when you're here, I just motioned to my heart, your family.
Oh. Okay.
Also, your blood.
Yeah. Ah, well, that seems like a good enough end to the show.
I think it is!
I think so. You know, good enough. We had some rousing discussion.
We did.
And,
I think inadvertently, we got to the second level of Ray and Alex Therapy Hour.
I suppose we did, yeah. Good timing, this being the 21st episode and all, we reach our...
We came to terms on our disagreements over your oatmeal plain woman on the TV.
Right?
And, you know, we made some headway into that.
She's good with brown sugar. So, of course, you can catch us on Tumblr, nomorewhoppers.tumblr.com.
That's
Twitter,
right.
Twitter, No More Whoppers. Facebook, No More Whoppers. Good reviews and iTunes are always a must.
Very soon, LinkedIn.
Yes. Yes, all we'll right. put up our joint resume.
Yelp. We mentioned Angie's List. Grindr. No.
Because then all the requests would be sent to me, because I'm the only one local.
Oh, boy. Yeah. Oh, yeah, you're like, yeah. And your phone would just explode.
Yeah, yeah, you don't have to say it, do you? Son of a bitch. Okay. Gosh, what else? And of course, as I've said four times now, some good nerd stories.
Send them in, folks.
In exchange you can either... for Alex's nerd stories, this is, like I said, a good opportunity. Do not pass it up.
Yeah, you can either tweet those to @NoMoreWhoppers. I wouldn't post them on the Facebook because you're kind of tipping the joke to everyone else. But can they send Facebook messages or something?
I don't know offhand.
Or you
I'm
could
not good with the Facebooks or the Google. I don't know.
You could also email me at alex.fraioli@gmail.com. That's FRAIOLI.
Wow, that's a big step.
I know.
It's very personal. I mean, now everybody knows.
Oh, shit. All right, yeah, don't do that. That's my defense for giving out my information. You know
Hold
what?
On.
Don't.
Are
you know
you
what?
Kidding
Never
or
mind.
Not?
No, I'm not kidding. No, I am kidding.
Okay, sorry. Yeah, well, go ahead and tell him also what you think about cute girls or Arnold Palmer's.
Can we post the pictures that you sent me? Can we just put those up and let the fans decide? But I guess that's not fair.
I don't want to make a big thing out of it.
Well, we already did.
Have
you listened to this episode?
I was kidding. I don't really want to rope everybody
in. I'll tell you what. About those pictures.
We'll make that as a donation bonus.
Oh, I forgot to read Jason's message.
Oh, nice going.
Well, no, it just under purpose for his donation, he said, because someone ate all your gabagool. And then he's right. Somebody, I'm not going to say who, somebody ate it.
Yeah.
We got to get more. Not going to lie, gabagool ain't cheap.
You can also email Alex where to get gabagool again.
Yes. Oh, man, where's my gabagool app already?
Gabagooler.
Gabaget.
That's good. All right.
No,
well,
no, it's just gabagool with all the vowels removed.
Yes.
Gabagool. folks, download gabagool.
Bunch of hipsters. Okay. Well, then that's a good end of the show. Thank you, everyone, for listening.
Yeah,
I've
we appreciate
Ray,
it.
I've been Ray. He's been Alex.
Yep.
Keep your nose clean, and we'll see you next week. Gold subscribers, stick around till after the show. We'll have the I'm Alex dancers. Dinner?
Is it time for dinner?
No, I've had dinner.
Oh. Oh, that's right. Time difference. Time paradox. Don't kill me.
Alex has died.
Whoops. You killed Mussolini. Time paradox.